Okay, hi. Right. This video, Ottolenghi, Loyal Kana, featuring Jordan Rakai. Of course, everything I do seems to feature Jordan Rakai in some way. I'm still listening to that record, by the way. Okay, so this is a piece of music that's come up a fair bit in the last 2 years or so. And it's a track I've actually featured a little bit in some videos, even in since we've been off. But I'll give a really specific breakdown. We had a look at the drums a little bit and something to do with the chords. But I'll just give a really short video here with a really hopefully concise and detailed explanation, and then something harmonically for you to think about here. This is a really good thing for you to just try and think about. And here's a quick thought. If you are really struggling for motivation, I think learning something new is the best thing. Like, change is good, therefore learning is good, right? If you're struggling to do things in thinking of things in relation to how you previously did them, you know, that doesn't surprise me whatsoever. Things have changed, so then we need to adapt. If you were not in the zone of, oh, I'm going to think of music in this way, it's a great time to change that. We all need to do that. Okay, so hopefully there's a new harmony way of thinking, or a new skill for you to take on board from this piece of music. Lots of Loyal Kana suggestions. I think I've got three in the to-do list, so we'll do this one first. Okay, right. I'll play it, and then we'll have a little listen to it, and then you can kind of reference what I play against that. This track is really simple. It has an introduction, which is just six chords, and then it has a riff, which is three chords, and then a little tag, which is just two. This track is in G major. Yeah. Which is a key signature, major key with one sharp, which is F sharp. So there's a G major 7 chord. Okay, G major. In the intro, you get a really common voicing. Sorry if you're getting bored of hearing me say this, but it comes up again, again, and again. First chord is E minor 7, okay? It's played like this with two open fifths. So you remember the hexagram track from yesterday started with this chord, which is D flat major 7. This track by Loyal Kana starts on E minor 7, but with exactly the same voicing. There's E and B, that's the root and the fifth. There's the minor third, and a fifth above that is the minor 7 of E, which is D. So E, B, G, and D, and that's E minor 7. Okay, the second chord is D over F sharp, and you can achieve that really simply by keeping the D on top. Move this G up to an A, thumb to first finger. Move the E up to an F sharp, and the B can come up to a D there. And that's a D major chord, so there's D major, as you were probably first taught it, D, F sharp, and A. But this one has F sharp in the bass, so F sharp, D, A, and the D is doubled on top. And remember, this is a technique I really like to teach, which is that if you can keep one note over a chord change, if you can keep one note exactly the same, that's almost always a good thing to do. That creates really strong voice leading, because some of the parts move and some stay the same. Another great technique is all the parts moving in contrary motion, which is to say different directions, but that's much more difficult than keeping one voice the same, which is, you know, for lots of you, is going to be an absolute go-to move. The third chord is G major 6, okay? So there's a fifth, G to D, G, B, and then not D on top, but E. Yeah, which you'll recognize in lots and lots of music. You Beatles fans out there, they are no strangers to the major six chord. Queen as well, massive exponents of major six chords. They're kind of rare in a lot of mainstream like rock and pop and R&B, but it's kind of almost like that top E there, which is the sixth. What's the resolve down there? I was always taught that should do that, but I was taught with really strict rules about harmony and stuff like that. So those are those first three chords, E minor 7, D over F sharp, and then G major 6. Then the next chord is A minor 7. And all we need to do there is, in the right hand, move this B to a C, which gives us a C major triad. But if we put A in the bass here, gives us a really, really nice voicing of A minor 7. That's one of my favorite voicings of a minor 7 chord, especially if it's followed by G9 over B. Okay, so that's non-contrary motion voice leading. Everything goes in the same direction, but it sounds really good. Again, why it's good to not have the rule of contrary motion. Sorry. So A minor 7, A to G. Quick point here for all of you. When you're building minor 7 chords on any instrument, but I suppose mainly guitar and piano, it's really, really good to have the root of the chord and the next note that sounds in the chord to be the minor 7th. That is a great voicing for dominant chords and for minor 7 chords. Obviously for major 7 then, it's a different 7th, but having root minor 7 and then the minor 3rd, that is just super strong. I mean, you can have a track just based on that. Okay. A, G, C, and E. G9 over B. Okay, so B is the bass note. It's a G chord, so A is the 9 because A is 2. If G is 1, A is 2. There's G and there's A. And therefore it's 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. But it's there. And then there's D and there's G. So there's the G major chord, but it's over B. So that instead of going G, B, D, it goes B, D, and G. Okay, but there's an A in there as well, which is good. It gives it a slight B minor feel. More on that in a moment. Sounds absolutely beautiful with a major 7 in there. And then that is absolutely two chords as far as I'm concerned. There is B minor, and there's G major 9 over B. Okay, I love that sound. Awesome. And then C major 9 here. You can do a pull-off. Pull-off is when you quickly go from one note to another. That's a pull-off. So from the D to the E, which makes C major 9. So here's the intro. And then the song goes. Played a wrong bass note there. Okay, so that's the intro. We'll get into the main chords here. There's the melody, G, A, B. First three tones of the major scale. And we get E minor, or E minor 9 here. So E, D, F sharp, G, and B. And we get this chord. which is cool. Now, this is a really cool thing for you to try out. Effectively, this is G9 over B again, but it's really close to B minor as well. B minor 7, that is. And both sound great, so do explore that difference, okay? That's E minor 9, no doubt about that. E, D, F sharp, G, B. But if you put all these notes in, you get such a rich sound. Okay, so we'll make it more like a G chord. Okay, that's G over B. G9 over B. Let's turn it into a B minor now. Really simply, let's move the G to F sharp, and we'll move that G up to an A. And that's really like B minor, and both sound so good. Here's the other version. So you can really explore. You know, and I know you guys can all feel the difference, the profound difference between this sound. This one. Just one semitone moving. So that's B, A, D, G, D. And I'm calling that G major 9 over B. Just drop that G down one half step, one semitone to F sharp. It's such a different sound. Okay. And for me, and this won't surprise most of you, I like having both. I like it being totally both chords. You know? Maybe not quite that thick, but... You can just add these things in. Maybe leave the F sharp off to C major. And then you get this C major 9 kind of sound. C, G, D, E, B. B's the major 7. Well, let's work down. That's the major 7. That's the major 3rd. That's the 9. 9 notes away from the root. 5th root. There we go. And that really is the main body of the track. And it repeats. And the last two chords, the tag, is just a straight, no ambiguity about that. That's just D major over F sharp, D, A, D again. And then you get the, like, D7 with that C natural, creates D7 over F sharp. First inversion dominant chord, really nice, which resolves onto G major. So the whole thing from the top. And that's the whole thing. All right, let's have a listen.
I heard this little lady must have felt the pain. Ask her mum if the blazing sun had ever shined again. I felt ashamed, feel the same, not her mother though. No, started like to laugh, got a son involved. I mentioned the past like a running joke and told it without all the rain, there's no sun in front. Close, to everything and nothing. Picture past the honeymoon and bluffing, where the wooden spoon is only coffee. Short of the discussion, but the roots can't maneuver out of nothing. I've been suffering these dreamy days. I'm reminiscing last time. Hold any memories of us, rather hold you every day until the memories are dust. Yo, we only call the train, cause you know I hate the bus. Never get enough.
Okay, that's it. Enjoy. See you next time. Big shout to Herbie, year one, for suggesting this. Thank you. Okay, see you next time. Ciao.